The main thing I love about science, its life and its endless possibilities.
I'm really passionate about both art and science.
For as long as I can remember, I've been in love with science, and more specifically, biology. I'm not necessarily too much of a chemistry fan, but biology is definitely a passion of mine.
It's exciting to see almost 1,200 people in a ballroom, and to see all of these oral and poster sessions, over 700, you know, oral and poster sessions, largely undergraduates talking about their research.
I'm really interested in research, especially with health disparities and trying to close that health disparities gap, specifically in communities like the Somali community back home in Minneapolis.
My project is an ethnobotanical project done at the Missouri Botanical Garden under the direction of Rainer Bussman.
This is my second time here, and I am studying carbon sequestration at Pea Ridge National Military Park in Arkansas, Northwest Arkansas. And this has been a wonderful opportunity, and I really appreciate the opportunity that the American Association for the Advancement of Science has given us to come and present our research.
For a lot of them, they don't necessarily know a lot of scientists of color. And so to come here and see that their judges are of many stripes, to see that they are able to interact at tables, you know, first kind of like with their own group, but then after that, branching out and being willing and able to interact with people from other institutions, they're able to kind of get a sense that, well, I'm not in this by myself. But it's a difficult barrier to try to get over when you may be coming from a community where you're not seeing faculty, you're not seeing scientists, you're not seeing engineers who look like you.
So what are you actually hoping to do after you graduate?
Well, I'd like to get into industry at least for some time, get some experience under my belt, and then maybe go back to graduate school after that so I can get like a doctorate and all that.
If you're a very good problem solver, if you've taken the time to go through your steps, let's say in the engineering field, if you've done all your math, if you've done your physics, I think that makes you a really good candidate.
Well, I think that the students, the underrepresented group students, have many of the same issues as other students. It's just that in so many cases they can't fake it. They think that because of their background that they maybe aren't as welcomed into the community of scientists.
And it's been a struggle because coming from a family with no college background, you can't really explain to them the stresses of academia.
I have dysgraphia and ADD. Dysgraphia is actually a writing disability.
I've faced age discrimination on different jobs, racial discrimination too. The biggest challenge for me was a 20-year gap.
There are so many pressures, and funding for students is always a concern. And sometimes students have to work beyond the classroom setting in order to pay their bills. But an internship would allow them to work in a concentrated manner, and they therefore would not have to worry about the finances in this kind of an opportunity.
So I went to community college and I didn't have a lot of exposure to science, and I didn't know which areas would be available as future careers.
Your personal narrative is really important, and that you have to understand that anything that happens to you, whether it feels like it's good or it's bad, it is basically going to help to shape who you are and who you can become.
For me, the passion is not being I guess the person that they see in the news. It's about just helping others, and I like teaching, and you know, teaching doesn't get a lot of attention compared to like all these scientific breakthroughs and medical in medical areas as well.
Being here at this conference, even presenting the research that I've done, is very hard for me because I'm not a public speaker at all.
They are full of nerves right now because for some of them they're presenting for the first time. And what we have tried to do within this conference is to provide a safe space for that kind of first-time presentation.
So my main research was to develop a stable GFP tag guinea pig cytomegalovirus, and we're mainly studying congenital CMV infection, and the main reason why we're doing this is that currently there is no vaccine or preventative measure to protect babies while they're in utero from the CMV infection.
We also have had an experience working with engineers at NASA during an internship last summer. And I was able to work alongside them in the lab, working with a test hardware, a detector actually, and I was able to shadow him as he showed me the different processes such as 3D modeling.
My family absolutely loves what I do. They think it's great. They're very proud of me. They all can't wait to the day that I become a doctor so they can tell everyone, all their friends, and my son, my nephew, my brother, whatever, is a doctor.
It's an absolutely fantastic time to be graduating in engineering because there is work absolutely everywhere. We have more work than we know what to do with because all of these problems that people have put off for years, the economy had some problems, we had other issues, the problems are still there. And the problems need innovative thinking that's beyond what caused them to begin with. So I think all of my classmates have had multiple job offers and our choice of fields and conditions for how we work. So there's simply a wonderful market for graduating young engineers right now.
Yeah, personally, I don't really care who solves the problems associated with chemistry and cancer, but it would be criminal, in my opinion, not to have students from diverse backgrounds there at the table trying to solve some of these problems.
I haven't been to a single meeting where I've seen as many students condensed in one area. And I think that's the value of this program. I just hope between AAAS and National Science Foundation that we can keep this going.